Hello, 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 friends and neighbors. It's me, Kicked Head. We are back on Thornton Farms. You can see the day is almost done. It's almost 6 p.m. And yeah, the fields are ready to go. Now, I have a confession to make. I'd already recorded a episode earlier today. I try to record it in 60 frames a second and with the full out scale of 1920 by 1080, but it was so choppy and stuff that once I rendered it and everything, I just wasn't happy with it, so I'm going to record it again. So a lot of the work I've done in that episode is lost. So what I did in that episode, just to recap, was I sprayed, if we open up the map, I sprayed fertilizer on this field and this field here because this one was already done. So we delivered 6 hay bales over to the sheep and we gave them some water, and then we sold the eggs. We had 40 some eggs on us and we sold it. It gave us $430. And then we sold a trailer full of wheat at $811 a bushel. Gave us just about $17,000. So you can see we're up to 21,000 now. And that's the reason why. Plus, I did a couple of missions off episode as well, just to give us a little bit of extra money. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and get started on harvesting. That's it. Try to get a little bit of harvesting done before the night falls. Now, we're going to need that, but we're going to need the trailer out first of all. And it's in there. So let's make sure this is all opened up. We'll go ahead and pull the header trailer out. Now, I haven't had a chance to put the trailers away, as you can see. Go ahead and drop them there. The front end loader is over at the sheep farm. That's where I left it. Go by the fertilizer spreader so we could fertilize the fields. We'll pick that up at a little later time, but let's pull this out. Go, and we're gonna need, I have an idea, let's come out this way and we'll go in the other side just so the header can be in the right direction that we need it for the combine to pick it up. Yeah, that will work. We could go do the soybeans first though. You know what? Why don't we do that? That will be interesting because wheat, we see that, or this is barley actually. We see that all day long. So let us actually just pull this back. Whoa, careful. Pull this back right here. Let's go get the combine started up and we'll pull in behind that and we'll follow that. Just like that. My sound volume seemed low. Should be okay. And pull that right there. And you know what? Let's give it 25 meters. That will work. Get that all going, and away we go, guys. So we'll drive over. We'll get the soybean started. Because that's a good crop, I think, to have first off, just for sale purposes, money wise. Let's make sure we head out here all okay, just to make the corners. Looks good. Looks like he might have got hung up. Yeah, he got hung up. Okay, so let's go ahead and shut him off for a minute. I don't know how he hung up on that. Okay. There we go. Let's go, people. Days a-wastin', we got stuff to do. So we do have 25 sheep. They are good to go. As soon as we get this over here, I'll bring that up and show you how the animal status is looking. Hopefully what we can do is we can start selling some of this yield that we're bringing in. That way it gets some more money brought up. And what we need to still get is I need to get a back mower, because mowing that grass field with just that front mower and pulling the baler is just taking way too long. So what we need to do is we need to get the back mower, get a big swath of that mowed out at a time, and then bring in a tedder and our windrower and pull it up into rows, and then bring our baler down through that way, I think is the best way to do. Now let's make this corner. Is he still with us? No, looks like he's dropped down again. So he must have got hung up somewhere else again. Yep, he must have got hung up somewhere else. So one thing nice about it is we have all this grass field now, so we have plenty of room to park our header trailer and offload. So we got plenty of room now. So let's go ahead and we'll just set this here for a minute. Let's go ahead and disconnect it. Looks good. Okay, where is he at? No, he's still coming. Okay, let's just go ahead and disengage him. We'll continue driving it. Save ourselves a little more money that way. There we go. Now, I explained in the episode that's not going to air now that the gearbox mod, Farmer Beavis was nice enough to give me a English cheat sheet for it. That way I can understand everything that's going on. Let me just hung up a little bit on that sign there. Okay, we're going to have to back out this way. And gave me the cheat sheet for it. But yesterday with the migraine that I had so bad yesterday, I wasn't able to get any practice in on it. So I'll try to do that in the next day or two, and hopefully next episode we'll be able to have the gearbox mod installed and stuff on it and running with it. There we go. Now we're pulling in front to here. Back up. There we go. Oh, that's why it wouldn't raise. I wasn't on it. Okay, so we got that portion done. So let's get this going. We'll have to go back to farm and pick up the trailer. We just come right up over here. Let's do the first couple passes to begin with. So let's drop this here. We got to open up our tank. Of course I got attached to PTO. There we go. I'll get it yet. Okay, there we go. We'll do just a pass. Well, let's make sure that we are. I want to make sure that we're on chopped straw. Oh, this doesn't matter. This is soybeans. It won't have it anyway. Yeah, I'm having a bad day. So mistakes are still being made. So let's go back in cab. Turn that back on, and away we go. Because we've got soybeans. It doesn't dispense any straw anyway. So there we go. So we'll do a pass or two ourselves just to get... just to get you guys something different to look at instead of having hired help do it all the time. And what we can do is we definitely need to get into sheep more. We'll get more sheep going out to get the wool production going, because you can see that's over $5,000 a pallet for that. We really need to diversify and get that going. That way we can get some of that fun money there. Try to sell another trailer load of the wheat today. Blue Spheres, Blue Sphere stores. We'll try to get that done as well to get us a little more extra cash on hand as well. And we got to slowly start paying off our loan as well. We got to get rid of that. Get the payments down so we don't have as much to pay. Okay, let's lift this up. I got to switch to there. Back down. And make sure we got our edge. Make sure we don't miss anything. Probably go over just a tad bit more. See how we're doing. Yep, not bad. Sun is starting to set though, which is maybe a good thing. Get some night harvesting as well. Utilize the lights and get the beautiful light aspect of the new engine. I really like the way they done the lights on Farm Sim 17. It's really nice, and it doesn't give you that lag fest that it did in the previous versions of Farm Sim. So I really do like the way the lights work this time. Might be missing a little bit there. Not bad. Now it is giving us chopped straw, interesting enough. That's good. I don't believe it would give us normal straw if we were to shut that off. Don't believe it will. I don't think soybean does. Let's do a couple more passes. Then we'll turn hired help loose. So the chop straw is nice. We can utilize that as our first fertilization thing. Now we don't have to plow this next time, so all we have to do is just take our cultivator, cultivate the soil, then we can come by with the seeder and seed it as well. Now it might be beneficial for us to look at a front roller cultivator, hook up to the seeder, and then come through, cultivate through the front and seed as we come along. That way we can do it all in one go. I have to see what that is, see if we have the ability to do that, see if we even have one of those front cultivators. I think there is somewhere. I believe I did download a mod. I believe there was already one on the mod site for in-game mod. Kind of keep this straight a little bit. There we go. And we are going to have to shut these gates. Careful now. Ooh, don't want to get killed. Okay. I think what I'll do is let's make a quick pass this way. That way the hired help, he won't get hung up as bad coming back down, back and forth this way. That just gives him a little room to turn around in. The grass is coming in nicely. So we'll have plenty of grass if we ever need to. For whatever reason, we can't get a field done quickly or enough, or if I should say that one field is not enough for us, we can go around the outside edges of our fields and pick up a couple more bales that way as well. We should never need to, but the option is there if we ever do need to. Okay. Coming in great. Right here. messed up. Okay. Let's bring up auto tractor. We'll go to up and down. That's fine. We can leave that off. We want to turn that direction, and away he goes. So he's going to be off. Good old Philip. Always dependable Philip. We'll get him going. Got ourselves gassed a little bit there. So he's off. He's off to the races. Let us bounce back over to here. Whoop, I shut it off by accident. Let's go back. We'll get a trailer, tipper trailer. And what we got to do, Beans, we got to bring it up here anyway. We'll just fill it up with a load a week, 21,000 liters. We'll sell that and then bring the trailer back by here. So that's going to give us a little extra money as well. And then what I wanted to do is show you the animals. So let's go ahead and do that real fast. So if we look here, you can see their productivity is 100%. We got 25 of them. The reproduction rate's about 38 and a half hours each. We got 24 and a half hours to go. The wool's only at 17%, and you can see they're 100% cleanliness. They've got water. They can stand to use a little bit more water, and they've got enough hay and grass. So that's good. The sheep are on their way. Now, pigs would probably be the next one to diversify into. That'd probably be the better one than the cows, because cows, you have to get TMR, the power food and everything. The only thing with pigs, though, is we have to have so much different variety of crops on hand to be able to feed them. You know, you're going to need the corn, the earth fruits, the straw, the grains and everything. So we currently are not in any position to keep them maintained. So we need to build up on some of our yields and stuff into our silos before we even attempt to get some pigs. But I think that'd be the next one that we wanted to diversify into and get them going. That way we could start getting manure and stuff as well for our fields. And if we just take a quick look here, I don't believe we have any earth fruits in store. Don't believe we do. No, we have none in store. So if we do diversify into that, what we'll probably end up getting would be under placeables, probably purchase this right here, root crop storage. Probably get that. That's going to cost us $90,000, but we'll hold 300,000 liters. And I think that would be the best thing to do. Instead of dumping it on the ground, we get it under storage. Now, we could do it in one of our big bins that we have here on the farm as well, and just buy a conveyor system. But I really think that tunnel thing would be the best. Let's just move this into here. Okay, we'll hook that up, and let's just disconnect this for the time being. Okay, now we'll just pull up under here. We'll grab a load of our wheat, and we'll take that down to Blue Sphere, and we'll sell that. Yep, start that. We're down to 62,000 because I sold 20,000 or 21,000 liters. We'll sell another 21,000, and I think we'll be good to go. There we go. Let's put the cover on it. And let's do it. How's he doing? He's 87% full already, so we need to hurry up and get over there. He's filling up quick with that, the yield. He's putting out a lot more yield than what we did the very first time we harvested that field. So the plowing adds 10%, then each spray iteration adds 10% extra yield, I believe, for a total of 40% bonus yield. So we should get quite a bit of soybean out of there, that's for sure. So we'll bring this down, we'll sell this just in time to be able to go back and offload him. Well, he'll have to sit there a little bit, we won't get there in time. But right over here there'll be a path through the woods that we can take. I believe it's not this path, but the next path, I think it is. right before you get to the railroad, I believe. Yeah, I think it's just right before you get to the railroad. So we got the water river, the little creek right here, the little river, and then we want to take this road right here. This will cut us out through the woods and come out just to the left where we want to go. So we'll have to make a left onto the road. So I'll make it to just to the right, sorry. So we'll have to make a left onto the road. Little bumpy trail through the woods here. But here's the road. So it did cut off a little bit of where we had to go. Make sure it's clear, nothing's coming. There we go. 21,000 liters of wheat, sure is heavy to pull. It's struggling. Okay, so yeah, he's done. He's waiting on us, so we'll have to get there in a second. And we want to make our turn right up here. Make sure the road's clear. It looks like it is, so we'll zip down into here. Now, last time I sold this, it dropped the price down $25 a bushel. So we'll see what it does this time. But it's interesting that it went right back up to $8.11. Okay. Okay, beans were off to the right side. Let's do this. Let's go here. I want to tip right side. There we go. And let's take the cover off. Let's pour it out. So this should give us just over 17,000. Just like it did last time I did it. Yep, 17,000. So let's go offload the soybeans now. I'm interested to see how much soybeans they're going for right now. Yeah, but we definitely got to get our wool production going a lot quicker than what it's going now. So it looks not clear. There we go. And the field is right here, thank God. Now hopefully he's not piping out over the crops and we'll have to... Nope, it looks like he's good. He's in the right direction. Yeah, you can keep that horn to yourself, buddy. And we'll come down here, we'll offload him. I'm curious to see how much he was able to, well, I mean, it only holds a certain amount, but he didn't get that far. We got, what, 2-3 passes down this side, one pass the headlands there, and looks maybe one and a little bit of a pass down this way. Yeah. Oh, no, he's got more than that. He's got a couple passes, so that's not bad. Start that pouring. That gives us some nice rich soybeans. Get these going. And what are they right now? Soybean, wow, that's pretty good price. $13.52 at Dalton. We might just take once we get the full trailer, we might as well just take a full trailer up there and drop that too. Get us the money that we're gonna need. That will help us buy some more sheep. And we'll have to see what else we need to get into. Now, there's a couple things I'm definitely going to want to buy. And if we take a look here, let me just set cruise control on. Let me set this down. Come on, drop down. There you go. Stop for a minute and then go 3. And 2. That gives us 6. Go. And we'll just follow him down to the end. Then there's a couple of things I want to show you that in the next couple episodes that we want to start looking at and possibly getting. Now, primary is more sheep and paying off our loan. That's primary. That's the first things we want to do. We want to get that stuff taken care of first, get our loan completely paid off. I believe we owe $65,000 left on our loan. If we pay $5,000 back each time that we get some extra funds, I think we'll be okay. Okay, so let's go ahead and I will move out of the way for him. Let's pull this out over here, let him go. Okay, so take a look. Under vehicles, I want to pick up this here eventually. It's a flatbed, but we can use it to load bales and pallets of like fertilizer and seed on there. This will give us a nice little work truck that we can drive around in. It's $25,000 with $20 a day. It's also got the auto load script, as you can see. This will actually haul anything, but it only holds 3,000 liters. I don't see a reason why we need this, to be honest with you. Plus, it looks too racy to me, too sporty to me. But this one we'll definitely look at into getting. If we come back, there are some things in the front end loader that we're going to want. We might want to skip the square bills, but I'm not sure. But this we'll probably want to do once we start doing our clamps or silage clamps. This will help us scoop up and get in there and make sure we get all the silage into the bucket. You can see it does a lot of different fruit types. Also, this might not be bad. As we start moving pallets, this will just give us a little extra stability. Definitely this, that way we can start stacking our round bales up out of the way and we can just grab them. Because what we can then do is we can purchase the auto loader for the round bales. That stands them up, and then we can utilize this to pull from the top and everything. This gives us a little extra reach for our front end loader as well. Also, speaking of front end loader, we might want to maybe eventually look into getting this to keep on the main farm. That would be helping out. That way we can use that to muck out the cow and the pigs. So that's something that we can look into eventually into the tractors. I definitely want to. You can see I got a lot of different tractors. If we pop out over to the mods area, coming up right about here. This I want to get for sure. I want to look at this. This vent right here is a nice vent to get. I'd like to get into that one. And if we look here, we got a lot of different tractors and stuff that I downloaded this morning that we might want to eventually give a try, but not right now. This is the John Deere that I want, not the Fendt, but this John Deere. This is nice. I've had this before. It's a very nice model tractor. We'll take a look at that eventually. Yeah, well, we'll need a sprayer. Our fertilizer, we have to figure out which one we want to go to. But once we start getting manure and stuff coming in down the road, we'll switch to manual and slurry trailers and stuff of that nature. Now, do we want to start getting into the logging and stuff? That's what I've been wanting to ask you. So if you want to see an episode or two of logging and stuff, let me know in the comments down below. We'll go in and we'll start out small. What we can get is we have that single axle bale trailer that we're using. We can load some logs up on that. All we have to do is invest in a chainsaw, and then we need to invest in, if we look in the front end loader, we'll have to go into these log grabbers. We got this one, or we can go into the modded ones here. We've got, that's a bale right here, these here. We can use this one. This one probably be the best we can get. Give us a little more stability, and we can load it up on a trailer that way and take it to the sawmill and lumber yard and sell it and stuff like that. But let me know in the comments down below. I'm going to leave it there, guys. It's almost 30 minutes in. I'll continue doing this field offline. We'll get this sorted. I'll sell the first load off camera, get that, get us some more funds in. And the next episode, what we'll work on is possibly doing some missions, our logging, as well as continuing with the harvest. So Thank you for joining me. If you like the episode, hit that like button. It really helps me out. Lets me know you like the content. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new and you like what you see. And follow me on all the social media, including Twitter, Facebook, as well as join the Steam group over in the Steam. Until next time, I'm a kick to the head. This is Thornton Farm as the sun goes down. We'll catch you all later. Have a great day. Bye-bye.